break that tie, that line, they just go on out. And you know, just keep on going. It's called the ring order, and you'll never catch it. So you shoot a rocket to the moon. The moon is moving, but the moon, you gotta shoot a rocket, kind of catch up. You gotta have the brains to do that, because that moon's in orbit. And if you break your tie when you get to your ship up there, and you're gonna walk on the moon, you better keep something. No, that's called another atmosphere. So it's all kind of atmospheres. Now, here, how did I get there? I don't know. But forever the work was, wisdom was there. Who is wisdom? Wisdom has a name. It has a person. The person is called Jesus. J-E-S-U-S. R. Not in that name. He was called the Christ. Christ, or you can say the Son, the S-O-N, is there all the time. You see, he's going to spell it out. I was there all the time. He said, I'm the wisdom. Jesus said over in the New Testament, it's about if you follow me, man, do what you're going to get. Verse 24, when there was no depths, this is stuff that we can understand, we can touch. When there was no depths, I was brought forth. When there were no fountains abounding with water. In other words, when there was no oceans, no seas, no anything that you as a human being can get, can understand. No Pacific Ocean, no Atlantic Ocean, no Mediterranean Sea, none of that. Before any of that, wisdom was being utilized. I was in partnership with God. Verse 25, before who?
The mountains.
Brother McClellan, you know about the mountains.
Yes, sir.
Over there in Korea, you can't turn one way from the other without seeing them.
Okay.
Mountains. Mountains. Everywhere you go, it's a mountain. You might be in a mountain. You might be driving through a mountain. You might be living on a mountain. I had a church on the mountain. It's called. You walk up there. You have to go to the mountain. You know, the church. Happy Mountain Church. So up in the mountains. Now, if you're over in Colorado or somewhere, California, you see some serious mountains. Before the mountains. Awesome piece of work. Before the hills. I was brought forth. I was utilized. Now, while as yet he had not made what? Verse. While as yet he had not made the earth, nor the fields, nor the highest parts of the dust of the world. When he prepared the heavens, he said what?
So I'm right there.
Finish that out. When he said a what?
He said a compass upon the face of the depth.
Now the depth. Now a compass, I mean, he says a compass, but here's what he's saying is that the earth, and scientifically, you got to understand some things here scientifically. How many took earth science in school?
I didn't.
Okay.
I didn't need the candles.
Okay. When there was a compass is like a circle. When he said a circle upon the earth, that's an invisible circle around the earth. And there's some things on earth that we haven't really discovered. Some things we have finally discovered. Number one, I don't know, when was it that when Isaac Newton and Einstein and all those guys discovered?
Yeah.
When was that? There was one time that we couldn't figure out why if I let something go, it doesn't go sideways or go up, but it always go
down. Gravity.
Yeah, why is that? You step off a building, you ain't going sideways. You ain't going up. You're going where?
Down.
And the more you go down, the faster you're going down. When you finally stop, you say, man, I got you quick. Step off the building. The next time you know, the boom. Whoa. Wow. So before God, he's saying that before you saw anything, I was putting those laws in motion. Mm-hmm. Law of gravity. Boom. A circle around the earth, which means that you can never step off the end of the what? Earth. People would have believed their Bible, Christopher Columbus wouldn't have to prove that the earth was round. If it's been reading their Bible, they would never need Christopher Columbus to go prove that the earth was, that you can never walk off. But they didn't believe. So he had to go prove that I could sail forever and ever, never fall off. Benjamin Franklin had to get a kite and a key. Prove that that fire right there, we can control it. We can just get a hold of it. If you don't believe that's fire, put your turn on it. I go touch one of those outlets. That's real fire. That's hot. And there's some invisible laws. There's some stuff that's operating by things that wisdom put down here. Wisdom can tell you how to keep from getting polio. There's a cure for cancer. Wisdom has it. What other stuff? Wisdom, we haven't what? Caught up to that fine lady. You know, trying to catch it. Still trying. Some of us think we can keep, make a shortcut and catch it. That's wisdom. Okay, let's see. Should we go on, or should I go get my glasses fixed? Okay. Someone read. What do we leave off?
Which one? 28?
Okay. Before we read 28, let's read Isaiah 40 and 22. Next book behind, a couple of books behind the Proverbs. To your left. 40 and 22. And what have we there? It is he, that's why when we said circle, wisdom is set sitting out there in the, just like gravity is working. Wisdom, Jesus is out there making stuff happen. He has a place where he is. And it says there in 22, and it's he that sitteth upon the what? Circle of the earth. And the inhabitants thereof are as what?
Grasshoppers.
You and me, we're just like grasshoppers. That stretcheth out the heavens as a curtain, spreadeth them out as a tent to dwell in. That's how awesome wisdom is. And he looks down on us and say, and that's going to show you that our mind is limited. His mind abilities, knowledge, capabilities is unlimited. That goes to show to us why we got to follow the person of wisdom, because he's got the answers to everything that you can come across. And he had the answer for, I guess it was Einstein or Newton. I think it was Newton. Why does the stuff go straight down and not sideways up in the air when you let it loose? Why is that? He had the answer for that. Thomas Edison, he had to try thousands and thousands of experiments to get a light bulb. And finally, wisdom kicked in and told him, this is what you got to do to make a light bulb. Make a light bulb. Fly on an airplane. Man, don't fly. Say that today, people are going to know you're crazy. Yeah, they fly all the time. There was one time when someone said, I think we can fly. And the guy says, I think you're nuts. Wisdom gave him the answer. Someone's going to come up with the answer. I got the answer for cancer. I got it. Somebody said, I have the answer for polio. Who came up through the era of polio? Could have caught it, could have been,
yeah.
But how many remember taking a little sugar?
Yep.
Someone had to answer. Who take this one? Take that. You all right? But somebody had to be the first recipient. Who would have stepped up to that? Yeah, take this stuff. I invented it. Keep it from getting poison. You crazy? Yeah, I put a little sugar with it. You'll be all right. How many would have been the first one in line? I'm going to the moon, JFK says. We're going to the moon.
He's oh my crazy. Goodness. Yeah.
So, wisdom helps you make it in life because it is the person of Jesus Christ who has always been doing stuff before there was ever an earth. He was active in stuff. He just did stuff just to be doing stuff. One time he walked through a wall so everybody could see it. Wow. Whoa. Walked off a cliff. Where did he go? The Bible says that there was enough room in the earth to hold the books about what he did. There's not enough room on the earth to hold the books to write about what he did when he walked the earth as a man. But how did he do that? Through wisdom. Not a musician. Wisdom. Okay, so where are we trying to go with this? All right, let's see here. Okay, verse 28. When he established the clouds above, when he strengthened the fountains of the deep. In other words, so that the water, they got their orders, opened the book of Genesis. God says, I want this much water, and I don't want the water going all the way over there into Tulsa. I want it to stop at Los Angeles. And I don't want it going past Louisiana. I want it to stop somewhere down there around Texas. And those places are called what? Beaches. Christians don't go to beaches. To see the wonders of God. Just look. Just keep looking at that water, and you can keep looking at it and keep looking at it, and it never run out of water. And I can stand here with my feet in it, and that water would not come over here and get me. Why is that? Because God said, don't do it. He told the water, don't do it. Don't drown Williams when you get in there. Let him play. That's God's wisdom. And you can't help but go to a high mountain and be on the mountain, right up to a mountaintop, like mountaintop anymore. You can't help but be there and say, man, how awesome is God? How smart is God? If I stay up here on this mountain overnight, I'll freeze to death. But if I go down to the bottom of it, I gotta take my shirt off because it's too hot. Wisdom already laid that out. Mm-hmm. But if you want to be cold today, go to the top of the mountain. If you want to be hot, stay at the bottom. Same city. Wisdom. So, now that's where we have verse 29. Someone read that if you will, please.
When he gave to the sea his decree that the water should not pass his commandment, when he appointed the foundations of the earth.
When he appointed the foundation, when he said, this is the way it is, this is the way it's going to be. Verse Genesis 1, verse 7, you'll find him when he told, this is what you do, water. This is what you do. You stop right there. Don't go no further. And if you've ever been into the depth of the seas, you can see that is absolutely amazing. Okay, verse 30, then I was by him, as one brought up, what?
With him.
And I was what?
Daily,
his delight. Rejoicing always before him. Wisdom is, I think sometimes wisdom lashes at us. I'm thinking the scripture just came into my mind, somebody find that. When God wants to be foolish, he's still smarter than me. He on purpose sometimes act the fool. He said, I'm still smarter than one of them.
Yep.
I think that's 1 Corinthians, 1 chapter something. The foolishness of God is wiser than man. So when God wants to be, just act up, just act silly. He says, I'm still smarter than the smartest brain surgeon now.
Yep.
But I'm just acting a fool, just being silly. I'm still smarter than any man that ever walked the earth.
Yes.
That has ever been born. I'm still wiser than him.
Referring to verse 20 and 21.
Which one is that, Sister Hill?
Are you referring to 20 and 21 first?
Yeah, let's see about that. Let's go over it real quick if we can.
That says, where is the wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the disputer of this world? Have not God made foolish the wisdom of this world?
Yeah.
For after that, in the wisdom of God, the world by wisdom knew not God. It pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. I'm not sure that's
okay, verse 25.
Verse 25. Because the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men.
The foolishness, again. So, because verse 25, 1 Corinthians 1, 1 Corinthians 1:25, because the foolishness of God is what? Wiser than men. Wow. And when God decides to be weak, his weakest point, he's still stronger than man. Now, so the reality is that, what am I following? Wisdom. Am I following the personage of wisdom? And it's easy to do. I mean, it is easy to do. He's easy to identify because God has manifested that wisdom in his son. And that son, that wisdom was with God from the even before the beginning. And you get into some of the debates. When was the beginning? What did it look like? When was it? What year? When was that? Before all of that that you can think back to where you think God was, wisdom was way before that. Yeah. Now let me see some of wisdom's work. See what he did. About that mountain over there. How about that sun that always rises in the east and the goes out in the west as the world turns? He never loses his spot. Come up in the east, go down in the west, you can set your clock by. We just got through with a month called leap what?
Leap year.
How do you figure that out? Gave some man the knowledge, come on in, brother. It gave some man the knowledge to understand that there's about 15 minutes added to every day that man hadn't figured out yet. What are we going to do with that 15 minutes? If we don't watch out, somebody's going to miss their birthday. So some man had to figure it out. It took years for somebody, some astrologer or somebody, to figure out that we got to add. I don't know what we'll do. We'll just every 4 years, we'll just call it, we'll just leap. Otherwise, the calendar is all messed up. And now, the complexity, the seriousness of wisdom is what God has for you and I. Every day. Problem is that we don't follow him every day. I think it's going to say, maybe in our lesson, that wisdom does what in the streets?
Cry
out what?
Loud.
I mean, you every day that you get up, wisdom is shouting at you. Do this. Don't eat that. Drink this. Don't drink that. And we hear it and we what? Don't hear. And then some years later, we say, man, I wish I hadn't ate all them, drunk or smoked all them, or didn't get, I wish I would have slept more, I wish I would have rested more. How many ever heard people say, I wish I would have got my rest when I should have gotten my rest? Mm-hmm. Wisdom been telling you all the time, go to bed, wake up, go to bed. I wish I hadn't slept so much. Wisdom is always giving you something. And he cried aloud, but in the middle of the public streets. But the Bible says, nobody's listening. They're not listening. Let's see if we can go a little bit further here. verse 30 of my lesson. I was with him as brought as one brought up with him. I was daily his delight, rejoicing always before him. Rejoicing in the
habitable
part of his what? Earth. Habitable part of his earth. And my delights are with the who?
Sons of men.
Who are the sons of men? Angels. Who said that? Yeah, angels. So when there was nobody, when we wasn't us, no earth, no men. There were earth, it was earth. But if you look at Genesis, it says the earth was one time was void and uninhabitable. But Jesus said, our wisdom says, that's the place I could go down there. And I took my boys with me, called angels. And we just had a good time. You have to worry about man trying to kill him or nothing like that.
Hopping around.
Look at this stuff. This is my stuff. Look at that. Whoa, look what we did. Ooh, look at that water. Ooh, Niagara Falls. What is that? That's called Niagara Falls. Anybody ever seen Niagara Falls? Oh, boy. How about the Grand Canyon? I'm about to get some. Grand Canyon? No. How about traveling through Arizona at the Rock Formation?
Yeah.
Awesome, isn't it? Ooh. Why can that rock stay right there and not just fall on my head? It looks like this stuff right here. This rock is going to come down. All this traffic going by that, it ain't going to fall. Cave up in Missouri. I got to find me a church. In the caves. Oh, man, you can go down there. Anybody been in the caves?
Yeah.
How about the fishes down there? See that? What's that? The fishes in the water.
Went to a place.
Ice formations. In the cave. It's cold in here. Oh, no, it's warm. It's a little bit better than this in the cave.
When I was a kid, I went to a place in Colorado in the mountains. Mm-hmm. It used to be listed as one of the seven wonders of the world. The full rock formations, you can see scenes from the Bible in the rock formations, and they said nobody carved it.
Nobody carved it. Yeah, that's what Jesus was doing. He's just down here just kicking it. Him and the angels just kicking it. And then one day, God says, let's make man. Let's make man. Okay. So what is that? What is a man? What is a man? You think the son might have wanted to ask the father, what is a man? What is that? Got any patterns, examples around here? That's when you find it in Psalms 8. What is a man? I tell you what, it's going to be better than anything we ever made. It's going to be outstanding. Oh, you're going to be amazed at this. First of all, we got a pattern. What is it? Who is it?
Right?
He's going to be made like us. Really? Yeah. We'll make him like us. What does Psalms 8 say? Anybody got anything? How are we going to make this creature? It's only about 10 verses in there, I think.
Nine.
Okay. What does it say? Let's read it real quick.
O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth, who has set thy glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of babes and sucklings thou hast ordained strength because of thine enemies, that thou mightest still the enemy and the avenger. Mm-hmm. When I consider the heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon, the stars which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. Mm-hmm. Thou madest him to have dominion over the works of thy hands. Thou hast put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, yea, the beast of the field, the fowl of the air, the fish of the sea, and whatsoever passeth through the paths of the seas. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth.
Let's make a man. What is it going to be like us? How bad is he going to be? Bad? Oh, he's going to be bad. He's tough. Just a little bit weaker, lower than I was.
An angel.
Just a little bit. I mean, Genesis, it says he's made just like us. Huh? Our very image. Look in the mirror.
Yep.
Is that man or is that God? But when you look in the mirror, you want to know what God looks like? Look in the mirror. You want to know what God thinks like? Get inside your head when you're in align with this Bible. He gets mad too, Sister Hill. You get mad anywhere? Ever been mad?
In your
27 years of life.
Okay.
Yeah. Blew her stack. That's what God did too. He blew his stack. Moses, I'm killing out everybody. Get out the way. I'm killing them all.
Again.
Now your people. What? No, they're not Moses. No, they're not mine, God. I said, no, they ain't mine. Wait a minute. What do you want? I'm going to kill them all. Get out of the way. Mad. How many ever got that mad? I'm killing them all. So he has emotions. It took a man to talk God what out of him. Don't kill him. It took a man to calm God down.
First time they didn't talk him out of it.
Yeah, the first time back in the flood, had nobody to talk to. Well, he had a who? What's the guy's name?
Noah.
What's his name? Noah. I'll tell you what, just you and your family, ain't but eight of y'all. Get on this thing. What is that? Is that a yacht? No. That's an ark. Get on there. What's an ark? I'll show you how to make it. I'll tell you, it's wisdom of God, building the ark. Do like I tell you, Moses, exactly as I tell you. Here comes the flood, had never rained before in the time of existence. You know, that's the reason why they said people lived a long time, because it never had rained until after the flood. They lived some long lives, because the mist was like we call it a greenhouse effect. Somebody put these plants in a house and they just thrive because the mist comes up out of the ground and it just gives you nourishment. And these guys live forever. Methuselah. Some of them 400, 500, 600 years. After the flood, the rain's coming down to the top.
69.
But they aren't getting that type of nourishment and stuff. So we don't live this long. We call it 100 years long. That's probably still nursing it, honey. They didn't even get married yet. Okay, so let's finish up. Verse 31. Rejoicing in the
habitable parts
of this earth. My delights with the Son of Man. Down there with angels kicking. Now, therefore, listen unto me, children. But blessed are they that keep my way. Blessed is the man that hear me, watching daily at my what?
Gates.
Waiting at the post of my door. So he says, you want to be blessed, you get up every day and you put an ear toward wisdom.
Skip verse 33.
33, yeah, it says, hear instruction, be wise, and refuse it not. And that's we're kind of like a people traveling on the highway, and the man is driving, and his wife is navigating, and his wife says, go this way, and he says, no, we're going this way, and pretty soon you're 3 hours lost.
Because
you
didn't listen.
Because he didn't listen. 3 hours out of the way, way over somewhere else, out of the way. What happened? You didn't listen. it's kind of like life. Yeah, you don't want to get lost in the desert. You get lost, and then you have to travel to California from here. Ooh, some places. Don't worry about a service station. You better have some gasoline. And if your air conditioning and car break down, you in big trouble getting across that desert from here to California. you're in trouble. Modern day, you're in trouble. There is no gas stations. Oh, man. You better have an air conditioner that's working because the windows on your car is hot. Air conditioning just a blasting. I'll never drive to California again. But you know, wisdom says what? Be prepared. And wisdom, every day we get up out of the bed, wisdom is shouting in your ear. Listen to my instructions for the day. Don't go to the casino. Don't go over there that way because there is a police trap, traffic trap, or whatever they put up. You come through, they're checking. Don't go. I gotta take a shortcut. I'm going this way. Man, something told me not to come this way. How many of us been there? Something told me not to do that today. That was wisdom. You missed it. You missed it. He was talking to you.
It was also grace.
Okay. All right. Verse 34 again. Blessed is the man that heareth me, watching daily at my gates, waiting at the post of my doors. For whosoever do what?
Findeth me.
Find what?
Life.
And shall obtain favor of the Lord. It's like that guy who's looking at that woman. Look what I found. Got to catch up. Some of them let it go on by. Well, brother, I gotta find me a prize. It's time to get around.
You never did read 1 Corinthians 1:30.
Okay, yeah. Okay, 1 Corinthians 1:30. What does it say?
But of him are ye in Christ Jesus, who of God made unto us wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption.
Wisdom. When you got saved, born again, wisdom jumped in your heart. All we got to do is listen. It's in the person of Jesus Christ. All right. It was a good lesson. I kind of like it. I like studying it.